Word up, homies, and welcome back to Dwarf Fortress, Fortress Mode. I am MC One of Jeff, and I will be busting rhymes at you live from Lash Crushes. So with that, let's rock the mic. Alrighty, so I'm working on a way to irrigate this. I'm not going to do a whole lot with really complicated stuff. I'm just going to do floodgates here, and then have it be just a real quick pull, let it flood in, and then dry out, I guess. I'm going to have a drainage system here, but I don't know where to lead it off to, and I don't know how much to deal with, so I haven't dealt with flooding underground farms for a long time, and it doesn't really matter because we don't have anything to plant under there anyway. But as we are surviving mostly on foraged foods right now, we are doing okay, I guess, because our overland farm is still good. Whoa, what? Where are my seeds? I don't see any seeds in here. Huh, weird. I don't know, maybe it doesn't show it anymore, or maybe I just don't have any, but either way, I've got a guy doing brewing full-time. Grand Elemental is brewing full-time right now. We're dealing with getting some inner stockpiles set up, doing bedrooms as well. I didn't realize that these were all made, so. But, yeah, basically everything's going according to plan, as if, I say that as if I had a plan. But, we've got that going, we got this going, our food and our drink situation is tenuous at best. I'm building a wall outside so that we can have a safe inner courtyard for our outer farms. I've removed all the upward ramps so that you can't get in from up there, theoretically. And I've also built a secondary inner courtyard here in which I can put crossbows, ballistas, or a trap of some kind. If anything should get through the outer walls. Also, we can put up guard towers over here for people to shoot at, but that's for later. For now, we are just trying to get an irrigation system worked out. We should have some more, we have some more dining tables now, which is good, because we were desperately short of those before. We're out of chairs now, of course. But, we don't have a whole lot of workshops up. That's something I'm going to have to deal with, because we need to get expand our horizons workshop-wise. Where are you going with that? What is that? He's carrying some cloth. Oh, he's carrying it down this way? How strange. I'm going to have to start up a fishing operation, maybe set up my own little fishing pool where I can have a safe spot inside of here for our dwarves to fish inside the walls. But again, yeah, that might be a bad idea. I don't know. We'll see. Oh, I just noticed something. The cats in this version, not only do they say that they can't, or they don't say that they can't bring food, but what? Small mammalian carnivore. It is usually domestic and hunts vermin. He is gigantic. His hair is chestnut. His ears are white. His tail is light brown. His head is auburn. His front paws are light brown. His rear paws are golden yellow. His skin is dark brown. His eyes are light brown. I thought it was cool because he's the pet of Sergeant Dude here. Here's Sergeant Dude gathering plants, and the cat just brought this to him from all the way inside the fort. He killed a firefly inside the fort and then brought him the remains, brought it out to his owner. Look, he's bringing in more. Look, I'm a good kitty. Oh no, he's carrying, what does he have now? Rat. I brought you a rat. Oh my god, rat. That's a cool cat. So the the couple layers of defenses here are done. We still have this. I think I'm gonna go ahead and link this part here up with the outside part so that it's not, like, crazy. But, I'm building a trade depot here, and I don't know how that's going to work. I don't know if it'll let me do that inside with these door setups. I don't think it will, but I'm going to try it anyway. It won't cost me anything to disable it and rebuild it again. Working on a butcher and a tanner shop over here, and then in here will be a fishery dissector. And I am going to make a fishing pond in here. It's just a matter of where. Because I think right here would probably be the best bet. If I made it, like a pond, like, about that size, and then I just filled it with fresh water, our dwarves could fish inside the fortress walls and also have a fresh water source. But, yeah, we'll see about that. Anyway, oh yeah, I just noticed something else cool. These statues here have stuff. They're like, they do things. There's stuff on them. I can't apparently see that one anymore, but like this one, it's a statue of dwarves. And I imagine as he becomes a better statuist, he will be making more finely crafted and more detailed statues about specific things. So as soon as we get a statue of Mansukar, I'm going to put him somewhere special to let everybody know that he was the one, he's the reason this fort exists. Now, all of our stocks of stone and wood are down, are up there, and I need to go ahead and move some of them in here, but there's no ready-made area where I can just sand out some, like, clean silt, because it's all mixed around. Like, up here would be a great spot, because it's all just siltstone, or sand, but actually, maybe in here, but now this is a tunnel. Okay, so yeah, if I do it over here, it should be okay. Okay, I figured it out. Alright, so yeah, I guess I'll do it here. I'll make a wood stockpile and a stone stockpile in here where I won't pile up extra stone by having it. But, okay, so we get a few more workshops cooked up, and we've got... We're running low on cooked food, but they can still eat berries and stuff. Everybody has a bedroom now, and that's really good. I like that. I need to move my gem stockpile inside as well. Also make it bigger. But I think everything's going okay. I'll make it like that for now. And then get rid of this other one up here. There's a whole lot of damn gems in this version. More than I know what to do with. But everything looks like it's going good, so I'll be back when we have more. Yeah, that didn't work. I can either build a ramp over the walls, or something. I guess I'll just move it outside. Woo, migrants! A woodcutter, a metalcrafter, a peasant, a dyer. For some reason, my dwarves are being remarkably retarded right now. They keep saying that drop-off is inaccessible, but the drop-off point is right up here. All they have to do is go outside of a door and walk around. Or go through that hole right there. It's silly. I don't know why they're complaining. None of the doors are locked. Everything's groovy. Oh, somebody fell asleep in the, spot where the doors put. No, Crazy's just standing there. Way to go, Crazy. You rock. Okay, so we're getting some more mining done, and the kitchen has been expanded with extra statues, and I guess we do need more gems there. More gem slots. Yeah, well. Figures just as we get the bedrooms figured out. More freaking dwarves. But, we got a spot here where I'm going to have a pond, and I'm going to build a wall right here. Well, I'll wait until the channeling is done, but, no, kidding, joking. No, it was like that. Okay. Close enough for me. I don't like the new channeling system, like how I tried to channel these two ponds into one and it created ramps instead of a channel. I'm happy with that. But the majority of our stuff from the cart has all been moved into the thing, except for some threads. For some reason. I guess we didn't have enough cloth stockpiles. Aha! Yeah. There we go. Make that freaking wall there, please. Please do it. But, yep. Everything's going good. Okay, so I've added Far Out, Base Orage, blah, 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 blah. Clan Rat, Sam Croft, Cute Emo Boy, Iron Man, and Duel as the new migrants. I skipped over Fogginel from the list because he wanted a baby, and I don't have a baby yet. So I'll grab him once he gets a baby. That's the only request I'm going to be honoring, by the way. If you request a baby, I'll give it to you. If you request a miner or a weaponsmith or something like that, I'm sorry, that's not how I play Dwarf Fortress. Whoever I want to do a job at any given time, I give a job to. So, next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress, we will continue our... Is that the wrong spot for the pond? Please tell me that I didn't just channel over my... Okay, good. I think. Okay, good. For some reason, that looks wrong. Next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress, we fill a pond, maybe get to thinking about building a depot in the right spot, and move forward dwarfily.